Greetings, Eric Bakker, the naturopath. Thanks for coming back. I always like people coming back, checking out the channel. Is magnesium any good for small intestinal bowel overgrowth or SIBO? I've spoken a lot about magnesium on this channel. Magnesium is a fantastic element to have in the body. I think it's the fourth most abundant element in the body. It's critical. It's critical for proper nerve function, but also for proper, you know, function of the or blood vessel wall, the endothelium in particular. So it allows an elasticity of the blood vessel. It's great for keeping blood pressure perfect, but magnesium does so much more than that. It's estimated between 300 to 400 different biochemical processes in the body are affected by magnesium. So even your teeth, your bones are about 40% made out of magnesium. So the uptake of magnesium really depends a lot on the integrity of the gut of the person. But from what I can gather from looking at many different studies, about 30 to 40% of the magnesium you swallow actually gets absorbed. And younger people tend to have a higher absorption rate than older people. So when you hit 60 or 70 years old, you know, sort of a bit my realm, when you're pushing into that sort of age bracket, the absorption for a lot of minerals just starts to nosedive. And so, you know, conservative estimates are about, well, being 60 now, I would probably absorb about a third, you know, of what a really young person would absorb, basically. So, but the healthier the stomach and the small bowel is, meaning, you know, the better the balance of bacteria, keeping yeast at bay, you know, beneficial bacteria at good levels. When things are humming well in the body, and particularly when the enzyme levels are good, the uptake dramatically increases. So whenever you drink alcohol, have coffee or tea, or have junk food or stuff like that, you know, and you're starting affecting your gut, it will also affect how magnesium is taken up. And this can explain also why many people feel different when they take supplements. You know, some people have got a gut in poorer state, needs to be brought up before it can accept those minerals, you know, accept that, really absorb them. So the ileum, or the terminal part of the small bowel, is where most of the magnesium is taken up in the body. Also in the colon, in certain parts of the large intestine. So there is no doubt that magnesium will have a good effect on small intestinal. Oop, there goes my flashing light again that needs replacing. Bing, you see it flashing. And so magnesium is a good one for gut products, but you need to be careful when you take magnesium, particularly initially take it, you know, as a powder or a capsule or a tablet with SIBO or a gut problem, because it can exacerbate things first. So just be wary of that. It can, you know, make the bowel work a bit faster or a bit slower, because it will affect the nerves in the gut. It will affect a lot of processes in the gut. But a healthy gut like mine, not a problem. I can easily take, you know, between 400 to 600 milligrams of magnesium without any issues. It's a fantastic supplement to take. I really recommend it. Now, you'll generally find magnesium bound to something, often an amino acid. We call them chelates. So chelate, I think it means to claw in Latin, to grab hold of. So when they bind magnesium, for example, to glycine, you know, magnesium glycinate, and it disassociates easier that way. That way you get a little bit of glycine in your, you know, in your body, but also a fair bit of magnesium. The older forms of magnesium, like the oxide, for example, and the phosphates, tend to be much harder to absorb. But the newer modern ones in most supplements now will absorb quite well. But is it any good for SIBO? Yes, it is. But take it easy when you first start, you know, taking magnesium. That's why I like it as part of a multivitamin. It tends to work better that way, you know, initially. And when you get more experience with supplements, you can actually just take the element itself. All right. Thanks for tuning in, as usual.